ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये। नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवती नैष्ठिकी। रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवत महापुराणम कैंटो 7 चैप्टर 9 टेक्स्ट 30। एकस्त्वमेव जगदेतत्तमस्य यत्त्वम् आद्यन्तयो पृथगवस्यसि मध्यतश्च। सृष्ट्वा गुणव्यतिकरं निजमाययेदं नानेव तैरवसि अवसितस्तदनु प्रविष्टः। एकस्त्वमेव जगदेतत्तमस्य यत्त्वम् आद्यन्तयोः पृथगवस्यसि मध्यतश्च। सुष्ट्वा गुणव्यतिकरं निजमाययेदं नानेव तैरवसितस्तदनु प्रविष्टः। एकस्त्वमेव जगदेतत्तमस्य यत्त्वम् आद्यन्तयोः पृथगवस्यसि मध्यतश्च। सुष्ट्वा गुणव्यतिकरं निजमाययेदं नानेव तैरवसितस्तदनु प्रविष्टः। वर्ड मीनिंग एकः वन त्वं यु एव ओनली जगत् the cosmic manifestation etam this amusya of that whole universe yat since tvam you adi in the beginning antayoh at the end prithak separately avasyasi exist मध्यतश्च also in the middle the duration between the beginning and the end srushtva creating gunavyatikaram the transformation of the three modes of material nature nijamayaya by our own external energy इदं दिस नानैव लाइक मेनी वैरायटीज तै बाय देम द मोड्स अवसितः एक्सपीरियंस्ड तत् दैट अनुप्रविष्टः एंटरिंग इनटू। ट्रांसलेशन एंड पर्पट बाय हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Translation: My dear Lord, you alone manifest yourself as the entire cosmic manifestation. For you existed before the creation, you exist after the annihilation, and you are the maintainer between the beginning and the end. All this is done by your external energy through actions and reactions of the three modes of material nature. Therefore, whatever exists externally and internally is you alone. Purpose. As stated in the Brahma Samhita, ekopyasu rachayitum jagadanda kotim yachaktirasti jagadanda chayayadantah andantarasta paramanu chayantarastam govindamadi purusham tamahang bhajami. I worship the personality of Godhead Govinda, who by one of his plenary portions enters the existence of every universe and every atomic particle, and thus ultimately, unlimitedly manifests his infinite energy all over the material creation. To create this cosmic manifestation, Govinda, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, expands his external energy and thus enters everything in the universe, including the atomic particles. In this way, he exists in the entire cosmic manifestation. Therefore, the activities of the Supreme Personality of Godhead in maintaining his devotees are transcendental, not material. He exists in everything as the cause and effect, yet he is separate. Existing beyond this cosmic manifestation, this is also confirmed in Bhagavad Gita. Maya tatamidam sarvam jagatavyakta murtina matsthani sarvabhutani nach aham tesu avasthitah. The entire cosmic manifestation is but an expansion of the Lord's energy. Everything rests in him, yet he exists separately, beyond creation, maintenance, and annihilation. The varieties of creation are performed by his external energy, because the energy and energetic are one. Everything is one. Sarvam khalumidam brahma. Therefore, without Krishna, the param brahma, nothing can exist. The difference between the material and spiritual world is that his external energy is manifested in the material world, whereas his spiritual energy exists in the spiritual world. Both energies, however, belong to the Supreme Lord, and therefore, in a higher sense, there is no exhibition of material energy, because everything is spiritual energy. The energy in which the Lord's pervasiveness is not realized is called material. Otherwise, everything is spiritual. Therefore, Prahlad prays, ekastam eva jagaditam. You are everything. Om agyanam timirandhasya jnanam janasalakaya chakhyurunmilitam jena tasmai sri gurave namaha sri chaitanya manohishtam sthapitam jena bhutale swayam rupa kadamaiham dadati svapadantikam bande aham sri guru sri yuta pada kamalam sri gurun vaishnavansa sri rupam sagrajatam sahaganam raghunatham nitam tam sajivam sadvaitam savadhutam parijana sahitam krishna chaitanya devam sri sri radha krishna padan sahagana lalita sri visakha nitam sa namam vishnu padaya krishna prishtaya bhutale simate bhakti vedanta swaminiti namine namaste saraswati deve gauravani pracharine nirvishesha shunyavadi paschatya desa tarine jay sri krishna chaitanya prabhu nityananda sri advaita gadadhara sivasadi gauravhakta vrinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna. So, in this chapter, where Prahlad Maharaj is trying to pacify the Supreme Lord Narasimha Dev. And Prahlad Maharaj speaking this series of verses just in front of Lord, standing in front of Lord Narasimha Dev, how after fully blessed and protected by the Supreme Lord Himself, and not alone, in presence of all the demigods, even His Guru Naraji was there too. Yes, everybody was there. In presence of whole assembly, nobody was dare to pacify the Supreme Lord. The boy, Prahlad, he trying to pacify the Lord. And when he fell in the feet of Lord, Lord immediately took him on his lap and started licking him and fully pleased and blessed him. So after fully blessed, so he is totally pure and surcharged with fully with spiritual energy. Now this boy Prahlad is speaking these verses. This is pure Bhagavata Tattva, Siddhanta. Because you can't speculate in front of Lord. He is there in front of you. How can he say something wrong? So he is there. And he is very furious for Mava. He can't say anything wrong. So he is speaking. And also all the demigods headed by Brahma Shiva is also there. So now Prahlad is speaking. And he started with very humble mood that how can I pray? I am from a Asura dynasty. Here Brahma, Shiva, the highest demigods, they can't pacify you. How can I? But still, by your mercy, I can try, if they are saying. And they said, oh my Lord, you appeared in front of me, not because of me, because of my devotion. No, I know that. Because you are Bhakta Vatsala. This is your nature. You are always following your devotees. And Naradji and Chaturkumar, they are devotees. So they want you to appear in this world, to kill my father and all these things, to protect demigod, to keep their words. Satyam vidhatum, to keep their words you appear, not for me. Who am I? I am nothing. See the humbleness. And said, you protect me, why? I am not worth the protection by you. But because Naraji. Naraji gave in my karana your mantra. So by the wish of Naraji, you appeared, not because of me. And you appeared from the pillar. When my father was ready to kill me, let me see who will protect you, who is your God. So in this case, you immediately come out from the pillar. Have you come out of the pillar? Vyamtim cha bhutesu akhilesu chatmana. You want to prove not only the words of your devotee are always true, not only that, you want to prove the other fact that your omnipresence, you are present everywhere, in matter even in the pillar. May not be others, we cannot see, but that does not mean that you are not there. Vyaptincha bhutesu, in every entity, akhilesu chatmana, in everywhere, in every particle also you are there. Your presence is there, you proved it. You just come out from the pillar. Such a furious fun. Just come out from the pillar. And all your this form, and your quality, and the most essential quality of protecting your devotee, maintaining your devotee, is beyond material nature. Nobody can understand all these things. And you always doing like that, your bhakta vatsalata is beyond material nature. But then this whole universe, cosmic, now this is, you appeared in this because you are beyond nature. So how come you come this material nature? How you exist here? How come this possible? It is possible because though this material world is your creation, but still, and not only creation, you create this material world, You maintain it and you annihilate it, but still you are out of it. You are not this material world. Maya tatam idam sarvam jagat vyakta murtina. In your abhyakta murti, everything is happening. But na chamasthani bhutani vasyamai yogameshwaram. This is your aishwarya. You are not in that. I am everywhere. I am inside everything. But I am not everywhere. I am not within everything. I am totally separate. How come this possible, Baba? This is possible. This is because this is your aishwarya. This is your yogeshwarya. So now Prahlad Maharaj telling, maybe this materially intelligent persons, knowledgeable person, they will understand how the Lord comes out from the pillar. It may be astonishing for them. But I know, because you are everywhere, because you are the only cause of everything. Ekastam. Ekastamam jagat etam amusya. Well, whatever exists because of you. You are the supreme cause of everything. And there is no cause of you. You are anadi, adir govindam. You are govinda, you are adi, but you are anadi. Adi of everything, but there is no adi of you. So guna vyatikaram, you have your external energy. This maya sakti is guna. By this guna, this material nature, this whole thing is going on. Creation, maintenance and annihilation. This is called guna vyatikara, the transformation of material mode of nature. All these things are going by your energy only. You yourself is not. No, you are not there by yourself. So this is, and this spiritual world by your spiritual energy, material world by material energy, everything is your energy only. And Prahlad Maharaj is telling, you are the alone. Sometimes we hear this philosophy, everything is one, everything is one, nothing is all, jagat is mithya, jagat brahma satya, jagat mithya. Something seems like mayavad, it's only one, nothing is, no variety. No, unity in variety. Though the whole material manifestation is there, so many things are there, but in the butt of everything, as the root, one energy is working. Everything. Here Prahlad Maharaj is speaking this truth. You, naneba, you yourself manifest in different ways. You, not you, your energy. Guna vyatikara, your energy transformed. Sometimes this is the misunderstanding of Mayavad philosophy and Vaishnava. They are thinking the Lord transferred. No. Why Lord will transfer? Lord's energy transferred. Guna vyatikara, not the Lord himself. How come we transferred without Lord's energy? If sometimes we see, it is said in Brahmasaita, jasya prabha prabhavato jagadanda koti. Sometimes we see, mani, a samantak mani. Samantak mani is a matter. It is a stone, but it has some power. It can create some amount of gold every day and without changing itself by his power. So he is a small stone without changing its shape and energy. If he can create every day that amount of gold, so what to speak of Lord? Why can't he? He can create unlimited universes without changing himself. No need. If the stone can do, why he can't? So that's why he is everywhere, in every particle his presence. Achha, if he is everywhere, in the pillar, in the earth, in the pad, in everywhere, in every creature, then why you are coming to temple to the Lord, doing arti only here? We can do arti here, there, everywhere. Sometimes people ask these things. Yeah, these silly questions. People sometimes argue also, now why you are going to temple already? If you people are also saying, Lord is omnipresent everywhere, Lord is there, then why you go to temple only to the deities? I told Hare Baba, you know that water is everywhere in the earth? Now, yes, I know. Then why you go to the hand pump? You dig here, what? No. though water exists everywhere in the universe, but you cannot get it. If you want to quench your thirst, you buy a bottle. You go to water where is available easily. So though Lord is present everywhere, of the temple is easily available, go and see in his form, in his deity form, spiritual form, his presence there, go and easily get it. Otherwise you take the deity, anything, and create a form and prana patishta, do, you can't do it here, everywhere is there. But it's already there, so go there. So, but that doesn't mean the Lord is not there, but we are going because it is easily available here. He's present here. And also Lord is telling that only thinking that Lord is in the deity form, not anywhere else, that is also Kanishta Bhava. No. Lord is not only that. Lord is everywhere. Yeah. So, Prahlad Maharaj now is telling, he is seeing Lord, he is telling, though other persons may not, for them it is maybe a problem to understand how you can, but I know you are the supreme cause of everything. The whole material manifestation, behind it you alone is there. Lord himself, he says these things in Bhagavad Gita also. Matta parataram nanyat kinchid asti dhananjaya mayi sarvam idam protam sutre maniganaiva. He says, there is nothing beyond me. What beyond? Nothing come equal to me even. I am everywhere. How can I understand? Arjun may ask him. Then Lord giving a beautiful example. The example he has given, sarvam idam protam sutre mani ganaiva. Sarvam idam. Idam means, idam comes to in water, in molecule, in trees, in earth, everywhere. Idam, sarvam. Sarvam idam. I am there, presence. How you are present? We can't see everywhere you. How can you see? Why? Now just like you see a garland, this is a garland. All these flowers, one after another, in sequence, they are there. They are not falling down. How come they are there? I am seeing, if you put a garland, you fall down. Why not? We can't see the thread inside. We can't see it, but we are seeing the outside only, the flowers. But how the flowers, different color, different size flowers are, one after another? Because the thread inside is there. We know that inside the garland, we can see only the pearls outside. But all these pearls are in their position because one thread is inside. That one thread, the cause. If one thread will not there, all these pearls will finish. They will be disturbed. All the flowers will scattered around. Unless, so Lord is telling, because of me, all the whole unlimited universes, all these planets, all these illuminaries, all the sun, stars, everything is in their orbit, is doing their thing, their existence because of my presence. I am inside everything. That's why they are in their position. If I am not there, nobody will be in their position. The existence will be finished. Everything is exists because of my presence. Gama bhuttaj, in this whole world, this earthly planet is such a heavy earthly planet. And there is no support, not hanging, not any pillar. It is just like this vacuum. Such a heavy thing. How come? Lord is answering, Gama vishyach bhutani dharayami aham ojasa. I am carrying, I am entering, here it is said that Anupravishta. I am entering in everything and holding it in my power. Because I am there inside the earth, that's why the whole heavy earth is revolving without any support. Don't think there is no support. I am there. It's my support. Because of me, it is there. Because of me, sun is everything. Madhvati, vati, vayu. Madhvati, Varsati Varsa. It's the rain comes because of my fear. Sun is working because of my fear. The whole nature is working under my superintendence by my fear. Maya dhakhena prakruti suyate sacharacharam. In this charachara, the whole material, everywhere the material nature is working perfectly. How come it is working? Because I am there. Maya adhikhena. Adhikhyata, sometimes it is translated as under my superintendence. I am seeing the superintendence. But in another sense, if you see, maya adhikhena prakruti suyate sacharacharam. Maya, my adhyakhyana, adhyakhyana means, adhi means adhikara, I mean in charge. And akhya means eyes. You know, sometimes we Kali Yuga people, all these people, we have full of cheating propensity with us. We want to do some work, even temple even, what to forget of in karmi stage. Karmishas also, the laborers are working. If there is nobody to look after them, the moment they are just finding the opportunity, they will go somewhere, gossip and drink tea or something like that. Somebody should be there, hey, work, 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 then they will work. This is our nature. Without somebody's banging behind us, we are so lazy, we are so crazy, and we are so cheating, cheaters, that we will not work. So the whole material cosmos, the whole material nature, they are working because they see the incharge looking us. Who is the incharge? Adhikari? Krishna. He is Adhikari. Adhi. Akhena. I am keeping eye. Oh, I am looking at you. So the whole star is looking. I can't do. I have to work. So everything, all the devatas, graha, chandra, everything is working perfectly by the fear because he is looking. That is called adhyakhyana, he is adhikari. The incharge is there, presence, he is looking at us. How can I go? He is looking at us. He will punish me, he will not pay me. So that's why the whole material nature is working everywhere. Maya adhyakhyana prakruti suyate sacharacharam hetuna anena. There is no other cause. Try to understand, there's nobody else, only I, only of me, everything is working because of my presence, because of my fear, everything is working. This is management principle. If there is no fear, then nothing will work. Maya adhikhana prakruti. So now Prahlada Maharaj is confirming in front of Lord, oh my Lord, many people may say many things. This devata, so many devatas are there, so many varieties are there, so many worlds are there, so many things. I know there are so many things are there, but in the bottom of everything, only you. Only you. And if somebody understand, somebody know this, that even Lord himself told in Purushottam Yoga. He told that yam यो माम एव असम्मूढ़ो जानाति पुरुषोत्तमम् जो एनीबडी माम टू मी मूढ़ मीन्स फुलिस सम्मूढ़ मीन्स नाइसली फुलिस असम्मूढ़ मीन्स हु इज नॉट नाइसली फुलिस हु इज इंटेलिजेंट यो माम एव असम्मूढ़ो जानाति ही नोज मी व्हाट ही नोज यू ना आई एम पुरुषोत्तम I am the Supreme Personality of Godhead. If anybody just knows that perfectly, yo mam eva sammudho janati, mam eva purushottama. I am only the Supreme Personality of Godhead. If somebody knows this, then just by knowing this, he will become all-knower. Sa sarvabit. The meaning of sarvabit means all-knower. He will know everything. You don't have to go to hundreds of syllabus and subject and faculties to know so many things. I have to go to know this, I have to go read this and then know this. I have to read. No, whatever branches of knowledge are available there in unlimited universes, not only this universe, in unlimited universes, unlimited subjects are there. You will know everything at one point if you just know who is Krishna. That's it. Nothing will remain. You will become sa sarvavid. Acha, just by knowing, just by, if he can understand, I am the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then he knows everything. He will become sarvavid, all-knower. Now, if somebody become all-knower, if he knows you, then what will be his duty, what he will do? Now, then, if somebody become all-knower, if somebody knows me, then he has only one duty remain. What duty? Sa sarvavid bhajate mam. The only one duty to do my bhajan. Yes. To do my devotional service. Bhajate mam. How you will do? Na sarva bhavena bharata. In all bhava, in bhava bhakti you will do. In bhava, sarva bhavena, there is four mukhya rasas. Sakhya, vachalya, madhurya. In all these rasas, sarva bhavena, then he will not do anything else except doing this. Because he knows. He knows everything, then why he will waste his time? So that's what Prahlad Maharaj is mentioning here in front of Lord. Oh my Lord, ekastvameva jagadidam. You are the only one cause of the whole universe. You are the only one cause. Nari Baba, thousands and thousands of varieties are there. I know the varieties. How come? Now this is only guna vyatikaram. Maya yedam, this is because of your maya. Your maya. Nobody can say, it is of me, it is of this, it is of that. No. Since the beginning of the creation till today, anybody is there, other creatures will not claim, only human being, they are claiming credit. So any human being, from the beginning of the creation till today, he claimed that, because of me the rain is happening, because of me sun is rising, because of me this thing happening with him. No. Only one person he claimed like this, he is Krishna. Yes. Mayadhakhyana prakruti. Mattaha parataram nanyat. Mam ekam. This ekam means alone one. This is oneness. Krishna says ekam. Mam ekam saranam braja. Don't go everywhere. If you want to be really fearless, then forget everything. Just come to my shelter. Mam ekam saranam braja. Forget everything. That is the final lesson in Bhagavad Gita. Sarva dharman parityajya mam ekam saranam braja. Though the Lord appeared, Arjuna asked Krishna, why you are coming always? Jada jadahi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata, when the dharma is, have some problem in dharma, so I am coming to fix that. Tadatmanam sujam, I am coming in every millennium. What you are doing? Na dharma sastapanarthasya, somehow, to establish the religion, religious principle. Religion, I am coming always. So now in the end he is saying sarva dharman pritiche, forget all religion, forget everything, give up everything. Are you come to establish, now you are saying give up. What is your project? To establish, sir? Throw out everything, give up? No, give up all the so called religious principle. There is only one religion, one religious principle. What is that? To come under my shelter, surrender unto me. That's it. That is the bottom of everything, all understanding, all knowledge. Surrender unto Krishna. Surrender to Krishna. That's it. Krishna himself is saying, sarva dharman parityajya mam ekam saranam brajah. Here also ekam. Though there are millions and billions of personalities are there, and different capacity, different qualities, different things, so many things are there, and you need different things. Don't go everywhere. Whatever you need, whatever. Akama sarva ko kamova mukhya kama udaradhihi tibrena bhakti yogena yajatah purusam param. Only the param purusa, only go to him only. The boy Prahlad, by the mercy of Lord, ही इवन अंडरस्टूड दिस, ही इज महाजन, सो ही इज गिविंग दिस सिद्धांत दैट इफ वी वॉन्ट टू बी सक्सेस इन अवर लाइफ, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू हैव सम अंडरस्टैंडिंग देन व्हाट इज दैट, देन यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड only krishna is the supreme cause of all the causes and just serving him under his guidance under his shelter that is the only goal of our life to know that ekam he is ekam his vani is ekam his formula is ekam his devotees are ekam everything is ekam it's only one so why you are puzzled if there is one thing to understand why you are our headache is happening no there is only one thing if you know just one thing that's it so that's what mahajan prahlad maharaj in front of the whole assembly of the demigods he is telling in front of lord even that oh my lord you are the only person the only cause only to be known only to be served and only that's it somebody may say oh bhavar singh there so many things are there deep vali bhutva bhutva praliyate sometimes creation happening then maintenance happening so many things happening then anil pralay is happening no this all thing happening because of him only it is in upanishad also it is said ato vai imani bhutani jayante jato jatani jivanti when there is a discussion between Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya after the 1 week of Vedic teaching so then Mahaprabhu asked well how Sarvabhauma ji how come you are telling Lord is nirguna nirvishesha there is three symptoms prominent symptoms are there isse apadan karan and adhikaran these are the vishesh symptoms of Lord हर जिस दिन करण मीन्स तीन कारक मीन्स अपाद मीन्स फ्रॉम हूम द होल मेटेरियल कम्स आउट फ्रॉम हूम ही इज द ओनली पर्सन फ्रॉम हूम एवरीथिंग कम्स आउट एंड बाय हूम एवरीथिंग इज मेंटेन्ड बाय हिज पोटेंस एवरीथिंग जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ हिम बाय हूम एंड अधिकरण at the end everything when finish annihilation happened everything rests on him goes to him only though three things happened because of him he is the supreme creator from him everything comes out he is the supreme maintainer because of him everything is going on maintenance everything happening and at the end everything when finish pralaya happen everything rests in him he is the final shelter but still He is prithak. He already said prithak. How come prithak? Though everything is happening because of him, but he is not doing. How come? How come he is doing? He is doing. He is creator. He is maintainer. He is annihilator, and he is not doing anything. No, this is how come. One time I heard Prabhupada was telling in West somewhere giving class regarding this achintya bheda bheda. That so then one intelligent person maybe they asked. Swamiji, I cannot understand how you are saying Lord is everywhere, doing everything, and He is not everywhere. This 9th chapter Bhagavad Gita, Maya Atatam Idam Sarvam Jagat Bhaktamrit, Mastani Sarva Bhutani, Nacha Mastani Bharat. I am not there. I am everywhere. I am not everywhere. I am not there. How come you are saying He is everywhere and He is not everywhere? When he asked Prabhupada, give very simple answer. This is Prabhupada's style. So you should understand that you cannot understand. Very simple answer. That this is the bottom of understanding. So we all should understand that we cannot understand. Yes, this is beyond our understanding. And Krishna is telling, "Nam viduhi suragana prahavanti na maharsaya." Krishna, Brahmaji also in his stuti, he tried to know in Brahma Vimahan Lila. Brahma tried to know really he is my daddy. He want to check because he is the vidhi. He is the original creator. He deity manual, deity worship manual also he by him. So he said, I know my father. If you want to feed him, then you have to fast, you have to be second initiated. First requirement, second initiation. Without second initiation, nobody, puja dependent on allow you. You can't enter into there. Forget. First you have to be second initiated. Then you have to know the mantra, tantra, mudra. And then if you want to feed my Lord, then first you have to take proper bath, be clean. And wear nice washed clothes, put dvadasa tilakam. Then go inside with talatrayam and go with proper achaman, with proper mudra, with proper plate, not in left hand, in right hand. Then this is the process of offering is there. And here I am seeing, these cowherd boys, they are not second initiated, not even first initiated. What to speak of second? These cowherd boys, they are not initiated first, what kind of second? No, genuine nothing. Not they have taken bath. They must have gone to toilet, they come without taking bath even. Not changing their clothes. And they are opening their box and they are eating. Krishna is there, Krishna is in the middle and all these cowherd boys are surrounding him. That day Mata Yashoda gave Krishna some curd rice. So he opened his, all the boys they opened their packet. So Krishna opened his packet, curd rice. So holding the curd rice in his left hand and some achar, two, three varieties of achar in the finger hole. And then he started eating. Then the other boy saying, Krishna, what is there? No, curd rice. Khatta. What taste is there? You are eating only this. Oh, I brought kachodi. So hot, so tasty. One bite he took. So nice kachodi. What this khatta curd rice variety? Krishna said, really? Let me. After he is eating one bite and Krishna is eating from his hand. He said, how come this possible? How come he healed my father? I made the procedure. Did you see manual? All these things I mentioned. These boys. How can they feed? Is he really my father? I want to check. Check. How can you check? He is taking breakfast. I want to check. If my father, he is the owner. Then he took the cups. Then somebody said, cups not there. Then Krishna said, okay, you have your breakfast, I am going. Everybody has full faith. If Krishna will go, then he will bring all the cups. We have to do what he can bring. Krishna went to search for cups. Then Brahma came and take all the boys. Krishna was searching for the calves and was crying. And he was shouting the name of the calves. Oh, these, oh, no calves are there. And Brahma is looking. No. Now I confirm, he cannot be my father. My father knows everything. He is all knower. He cannot know her. His son, I am doing this. He cannot understand. No. And he said, the boys are not there. Still he is crying for the boys. No. And he said, okay, now let me see what we will do. He is alone. No calves, no boys. Now at the end of the day, he will go alone to his village. Without any friends, without any calves, how will go? Everybody will chastise him. Let me see what we will do. In between, many things happen. So when at the end of the day, when Brahma comes and saw, all the calves are as there, all the boys are there, same thing is going on. Brahma can't figure it out. What happened? I took them, they come back or what? My potency is useless. He go and check. Brahma, they are sleeping there. The boys, they are there. These boys, two sets. Which are original, which are duplicate? Because Brahma was thinking that he was the supreme creator. All the entities are created by him according to karma. But he could not understand that some entities are there beyond karma. These boys and calves, they are beyond Brahma's creation. They are directly expanse of the Lord, expanse of his father. He cannot understand it. He was thinking these Brajavasis, they are my creation. So now he saw who are they are here. What is going on here? 3-4 times he back and forth. He become totally finished what to do by seeing the sun is totally in a puzzled condition. Then Lala, Krishna said, okay, now Brahma is too much in trouble. So he said, okay, Brahma's worshipable Lord is 4-handed Narayana. He said, all calves, all boys, all everything becomes 4-handed Narayana. Brahma became more puzzled. What? All my worshipable Lord, all the calves are Narayana. All the boys are Narayana, all 400 forms. Then he understood, oh, I have done a serious mistake. I tried to check my father. This serious mistake I have committed. I can't understand. I thought, I checked, this is how come they are doing. And they are beyond my jurisdiction. They are beyond my creation. Oh, 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 I have done biggest mistake. So he started asking forgiveness. So he fell down. They are totally dandavat pranam. And for us, dandavat pranam is busy because we have only one head. Well, Brahma has 4 heads. You have to take 4 turns to complete his dandavat. Because one time dandavat, one head, then one turn, another head, then another turn, third head, another turn, four head, totally 360-degree turn, then his dandavat will complete. So he was loading like that, doing dandavat pranam and forgiveness. Krishna didn't look at him. He said, you Brahma, you are trying to check me. Who are you? So then Brahma started doing stuti. In that stuti he is telling, Janantu eva janantu. May some people claim that I know Lord. Let them bogus claim like that. But I Brahma, the son of Krishna, the student of Krishna, the supreme creator, I am declaring hereby that I don't know. Nobody knows. There is no way to know him. That is declaration. Janantu eva janantu. Tava gochara, agochara, tava mahima, nobody can know your mahima, agochara, no. But then nobody can know, only somebody can know, only the Mahabhagavatas, only the bhaktas, they can, how they will know, nobody can know. Okay, we can't know Krishna, but Krishna is powerful. If he want, he can make us know. He can make us know. So the bhaktas, by the anugraha of Krishna, by the mercy of Krishna, they will understand. So the Prahlad Maharaj, though he is just boy, mere boy, but by the mercy of the Lord Narasingadev, he could understand. That's why he is telling this supreme philosophy. Oh my Lord, you are the only one person, the cause of everything, supreme cause of everything. You are the one. The whole material cosmic manifestation, as there are so many variegatedness there, but behind the whole screen, only you are there. Your energies are working. Gunam vyatikaram. Your energies has getting transformed and everything happening, but you are totally unchanged. Remain as it is. Same thing. So, by understanding, realizing things, I am only worshipping you. I am only pacifying you, oh my Lord. So this is the supreme understanding, the purport of all Vedic essence, knowledge. That's what Prahlad Maharaj, after getting fully blessed and protected by Lord, he is speaking in front of Lord, in presence of the whole assembly of demigods. Hare Krishna. Any comments or questions? What, 65? Slope 65 and 66. Yes. Yes. Of course, that is fact. He should only do that. Then he should become first bhakta, na? He has to give his, he should manmana bhavad bhakta. You have to give his mind and become his devotee. And a devotee, what is the duty of the devotee? Duty of devotee is all what we are doing, preaching. Preaching is the one of the major duty of the devotee. So if he becomes devotee to surrender him, then he has to follow his instruction. And his instruction is that, to preach. Okay? If you want to follow him, become his devotee, and surrender unto him, then you have to follow his words. That's what he's saying. Okay? Anything else? ग्रंथराज श्रीमद्भागवत महापुराण की समवेत भक्त वृंद की